Hello there! It is your mom of three in NYC, and I'm back with another video. Yay! Welcome! Welcome, welcome, welcome. If this is your first time on my channel, come on in. It's awesome to have you. My name is Taneza. I am the mother of three studious baby girls doing her homework as we speak. Studious kids living in the heart of New York City. Well, we'd love to have you. All you have to do is smash that subscribe button below and you've joined our adventure. All right, let's jump into it. This video is a review of 1 Samuel chapters 25 and 26. Let's get into it. Guys, Samuel, I'm a fan. I'm a fan. Samuel died, you guys. David moved into the desert of Maon, M-A-O-N. There was a very wealthy man named Nabal. When I read that, though, Bible scholars, I thought of Nadal. You know, a tennis champion. And there was a man named Nabal. And so we know, Bible scholars, that in the Bible, names have meaning. I looked up the name Nabal. It means wilt or failure. Being shamelessly improprietous. It's not so good, right? Nabal had 1,000 goats. Imagine that, 1,000. 3,000 sheep. He also had a wife named Abigail. The name Abigail means cause of joy, my father's joy. Abigail was not only beautiful, she was very, very intelligent. She was the opposite of her husband, who was mean and surly. And surly means bad-tempered and unfriendly. I wanted to read for you guys in chapter 25, verses 5, 6, 7, and 8. I don't want to forget to mention, I'm reading out of the NIV version of the Bible. Whatever translation you have is perfect. Just stick with it. You do not need a Bible. I will put every verse I read on the screen as well. Also, this Bible is a gift to me by my now husband and boyfriend in 2006. And so I do like to read all the verses that he underlined out loud to share it with my Bible scholars. All right, so we got Abigail and Nabal. Verse 5, 6, 7, and 8. So David, who was in the desert, sent 10 young men and said to them, "Go up to Nabal at Carmel. Greet him in my name. Say to him, long life to you, good health to you and your household, and good health to all that is yours. 7. Now I hear it is sheep shearing time. When your shepherds were with us," remember David is speaking to Nabal, "we did not mistreat them. The whole time they were at Carmel, nothing of theirs was missing. Ask your own servants and they will tell you. Therefore, be favorable toward my young men, since we come at a festive time. Please give your servants and your son David whatever you can find for them." So David is asking for provisions, right? Food, drink, to sustain his men. David's men gave Nabal the message. Nabal questioned who David was. Verse 11. "Why," Nabal is speaking, "should I take my bread and water and the meat I have slaughtered for my shearers and give it to men coming from who knows where?" After David's men reported back to him, he gathered 400 of his men. They put on their swords. Verses 14, 15, and 16. One of the servants told Nabal's wife Abigail, "David sent messengers from the desert to give our master his greetings, but he hurled insult at them. Yet these men were very good to us. They did not mistreat us the whole time we were out in the fields. Near them, nothing was missing." Again, this man had 1,000 goats, 3,000 sheep. Verse 16, "Night and day, they were a wall around us. All the time, we were herding our sheep near them." The Bible says that Abigail lost no time. You know, I love a list. Look at all that she got ready to give to David. She took 100 loaves of bread, 200 skins of wine, 5 dressed sheep, 5 seas of roasted grain, 100 cakes of raisins, and 200 cakes of pressed fig. Abigail did not tell Nabal, but she loaded all on donkeys and left with some servants. Abigail actually ran into David as David was headed her way. This is 23, 24, and 25. When Abigail saw David, she quickly got off her donkey, bowed down before David with her face to the ground. She fell at his feet. She said, "My Lord, let the blame be on me alone. Please let your servant speak to you. Hear what your servant has to say. May my Lord pay no attention to that wicked man, Nabal." That's her husband. That is her husband. He is just like his name. His name is Fool. Folly goes with him. But as for me, your servant, I did not see the men my master sent. Again, I so respect the fact that she is humbling herself before David. David responds to Abigail, verses 32 and 33. He said to Abigail, "Praise be to the Lord, the God of Israel, who has sent you today to meet me. May you be blessed for your good judgment and for keeping me from bloodshed this day and from avenging myself with my own hands." David explains to Abigail that she has literally saved the lives of all Nabal's men by her actions. Verse 35, David accepted from her hand what she had brought him. Remember, loaves of bread, skins of wine, dressed sheep, raisins, pressed fig. And he had said, "Go home in peace. I've heard your words and granted your request." Abigail returned home. Nabal was feasting and drinking. She waited until the next morning when Nabal was sober to tell him all that had happened. In the Bible, it says his heart failed him. I thought maybe it's a heart attack. And then verse 38, 10 days later, the Lord struck Nabal and he died. David hears of Nabal's death and praises God for punishing Nabal on his behalf. Is that vindication? David sends servants to Abigail, asking her to be his wife. Verse 42, Abigail quickly got on a donkey, attended by her 5 maids, went with David's messengers, and became his wife. Chapter 26. So David David spares Saul's life. David is in hiding. My husband actually underlined verse 5 and 6. So I'll read those aloud, and I actually will go to verse 7. David set out and went to the place where Saul had camped. He saw where Saul and Abner, son of Ner, the commander of the army, had laid down. Saul was lying inside the camp with the army encamped around him. David then asked Ahimelech the Hittite and Abishai, son of Zeruiah, Joab's brother, "Who will go down into the camp with me to Saul?" "I'll go with you," said Abishai. So David and Abishai went to the army by night, and there was Saul, lying asleep inside the camp with his spear stuck in the ground near his head. Abner and the soldiers were lying around him. Even after all that Saul had done to him, David still remains obedient. I have in my notes, Bible scholars, how often do we allow others' disobedience to lead to our own disobedience? We cannot let that happen. Let the other party, whether it's a boss or an ex-friend, whatever, let them be disobedient over there. You still remain obedient. Saul and all his men were put into a deep sleep, the word says, by the Lord. David was able to approach Saul without waking him nor his men. David took Saul's spear and Saul's water jug. Remember, they were right next to his head while he was laying sleeping. David was able to come through all the soldiers that surrounded Saul to Saul's head, literally. When David is talking to Abner, Saul recognizes his voice. David confirms that it is indeed him. He asks Saul, David asks Saul, what is he guilty of? What am I guilty of? Why are you pursuing me? I wanted to read for you verses 21, 22, 23, 24, and 25. Last five verses of chapter 26. Saul said, I have sinned. Come back, David, my son. Because you considered my life precious today. Again, this is twice now. Once when Saul went to the cave to relieve himself, David was there. Got close enough to cut off the cloth of his robe. And now a second time, he was literally right there at his head. Because you considered my life precious today, I will not try to harm you again. Surely I have acted like a fool and have erred greatly. Here is the king's spear, David answered. Let one of your young men come over and get it. Verse 23, the Lord rewards every man. The Lord rewards every man for his righteousness and his faithfulness. The Lord delivered you into my hands today, but I will not lay a hand on the Lord's anointed. As surely as I valued your life today, so may the Lord value my life and deliver me from all trouble. Then Saul said to David, may you be blessed, my son David. You will do great things and surely triumph. So David went on his way and Saul returned home. All right, Bible scholars, that concludes our review, 1 Samuel chapters 25 and 26. I look forward to seeing you in our next review, 1 Samuel chapters 27 and 28. Have an amazing rest of your day, and I'll see you in our next review. Bye, Bible scholars.